I was born in a holy mountain, Kailash. The mountain is situated in the border of Tibet and in Nepal, but it belongs to Tibet. So I was born there near a village. Was born there, and so after age six, then my parents became. To Nepal to as a pilgrimage to get a blessing from the birthplace of Lord Buddha from Nepal, from all the stupas, from the monasteries, things like that. And we spent around 2 years. So during that time, my father passed away because of fever, he passed away. So we couldn't go back. So my mother and me, we stayed. And I admit in a monastery to learn all this spiritual rituals, meditation, and prayers. You know? So, and then I was in Pokhara, no? Yeah, Pokhara. And then I also went in school where you can learn Tibetan language, Nepali language, English language. And like this, in Pokhara, I stayed almost 8-9 years. So, after that, in 1969, I was very fortunate. I was selected to admit in Varanasi Sanskrit University, where I could learn all these teachings of Buddha, all the philosophies and teachings of Hinduism and Buddhism. So I learned, I went there to learn all the philosophies. 10 years I studied. So 1969 until 1979, so until I become a doctor of philosophy and religion. So after that, my root master, 16th Gyalwa Karmapa, he invited me in the Rumdik Monastery in Sikkim. And he selected me, saying that, Tanpai, now you have learned all this intellectual knowledge. You know, now you have to practice it, you know, to reach enlightenment. You must practice the knowledge, the wisdom that you have learned. You have to practice it so that you have the realization of the divine truth of all phenomena, that you become an enlightened master. So then after that, you should visit all over the world. You should teach the world, you know. And you should remove ignorance of all human beings, and you should enlighten the world and all human beings. So my master, 16th Gyalwa Karmapa, was very kind. He selected me. Then there I stayed 4 years. 4 years in the retreat center in the Rumtik. And same time before I complete my retreat, half a year before, 16 Gyalwa Karmapa passed away in the Rumtik monastery. So there was a mixture of sadness, you know, because when I go out, after finished retreat, I couldn't see him because he passed away already. So anyway, nevertheless, His Holiness have told his assistants, his region, he's a representative that I should go to Europe to teach European countries. So I went, first European country where I went to teach was Denmark, Germany, Denmark. So 1984, I went to teach the philosophy, meditation, and all these things in Europe. So I keep on traveling many part, different part of European countries, and then teach meditation and teach people how to develop loving heart, how to practice tolerance, and how to win our inner enemy of egoism and anger, and how to transform anger and egoism into loving heart, and very important to serve the universal loving heart that you learn, that you practice, should take a universal responsibility to help all human beings, and to help all mother sentient beings, to serve all mother sentient beings, to help all sentient, mother sentient beings, and ultimately to enlighten all mother sentient beings, and like that. So I think I inspired countless European students that they start to practice loving heart, that they start to practice the supreme wisdom enlightenment, they become perfect spiritual holy men, women. So I think I have inspired thousands of many European people, you know? But I don't call them, they are my students. I just say these are my friends, you know? And I don't dominate them, and I don't possess them. They are free to come to me to learn, and then when they go to other masters, I rejoice. I say, that's very good, you know? And I teach the divine essence of all religion. You know, I think if everybody emphasize the difference, then everybody have a lot of idea to that we are all different, that we have a different belief, we have a different God, a different religion, and the separating idea will taking place in heart of every religion when they start every if you concentrate difference. Now here I teach is that we concentrate the common essence, you know? Like to practice universal loving heart is a common essence of a Christian religion. Practice universal loving heart, common essence of a Hindu religion, Buddhist religion, and Islamic religion. So instead we concentrate the difference. If we concentrate the common divine essence of all religion, then we can all meet together, you know. And our common essence of all religion is to practice universal loving heart, practice tolerance, forgiveness, practice divine wisdom, divine spiritual knowledge, to remove ignorance, and practice universal loving heart and transform the egoism into loving heart. And then also wish all religious people, after we practice universal loving heart, practice the supreme wisdom enlightenment, then we should all take the universal responsibility to serve our world, you know, with the universal loving heart, to serve our world, to enlighten our world, to bring happiness to everyone, and make everybody to win, you know? If there's a loser, the loser will be very unsatisfied, and he will start create a lot of troubles, you see. So I teach the world that we should help everyone and make everyone to win, make everyone happy. You know, when everybody is a winner, then this world will be indeed a world of peace, world of unity, world of oneness, you know. That's what I teach, you know. So anyway, and then 1990, I bought this area, this land, and then I started to build Royal White Monastery. You know? And so this Royal White Monastery, I complete, started to build in 1990 and finished around end of 1993. So this monastery has become home of all religion, home of all the friends who come, they can feel home, everybody feel home. And everybody get a free accommodation. Everybody get a nice breakfast, lunch, dinner, I hope, you know. And there's no talking about money. There's no tension, no stress about money. Because I think where there's like involved taking and giving money, there's stress and tension, you know. There's there doesn't have real happiness, real love. So I want to create a different part of the world that I can feed all and teach all freely, you know. Like our parents, when we came in this world, our mother feed us, give us the clothing, give us free service, you know. So in order to pay the kindness of our mother, I promise to feed everyone free, you know. And I also promise to teach everyone free, because my masters, they teach me free, you know. So in Europe when I teach, I don't charge entrance fee, I don't charge tax. Of course, if people who are very satisfied, very blessed, if they want to give some little offering, contribution, of course I accept, because through this I have to maintain this monastery, providing food for the monks. And also in Kunhegis I have Hungarian and Romanian students who are practicing meditation. And some of them they can sponsor, some of them cannot sponsor, I have to sponsor them, you know. So in this way my life's going on, you know. So same time I'm quite a little bit sad, because now I'm 60 over years old, and I couldn't bring real happiness, real peace, unity for the world, because the world is too complicated, you know. And I tried to engage all the religious leaders, all the people in this world, since 20 years, that everybody come together and bring peace, unity and happiness to the world. This is the most important moment for all, for everyone to concentrate, to bring peace, unity and bring happiness to everyone. Because here, we in this world now, as we are passing through a dark age, we have to go through so many obstacles, financial obstacles, and then political obstacles, and a lot of dispute, you know. So the all human beings are experiencing the maximum suffering, fear, and crisis. So the only way we solve this financial crisis, moral crisis, and economic crisis is that all human beings become more loving, less selfish, more loving, that all human beings start to respect each other, love each other, that all human beings start to forgive each other and tolerate each other, and all human beings start to take responsibility to protect each other, love each other, including our beautiful Mother Earth. So if heart of all human beings are united to protect each other, to love each other, serve each other, then this world will be a beautiful world. A beautiful world of peace, world of unity, world of happiness. That's what exactly what the God wants and Buddha wants. And so we human beings should fulfill the wish of God, wish of Buddha, a wish of ourselves to make ourselves very happy and to make our world very happy. And we serve happiness for everyone. No, I think this is the final wish of God, blessing of God, and absolutely the final necessary of this world. So I hope that you will, through this media, through your loving heart, you will carry this message that Master Tanpa is with his loving heart, he give this message that all human being should give up fixation, attachment to this life, because this life is like a dream, it's like illusion. This life itself, you know, one day we took birth in this world, one day we die, we go with empty hand. The only thing what we can do is to take the opportunity of this life. We human beings are born as children of God. We were born as a divine being. So we human beings are born here with a divine mission, you know, that our lost soul, the soul or mind which is lost and ignorant and egoism, we have to fetch it, we have to rescue our lost soul in our divine nature, you know, by practicing universal loving heart, by practicing the supreme wisdom enlightenment, we can rescue our lost soul from ignorant egoism, and then our lost soul, our nature of mind, reach enlightenment. And nature of mind, reach enlightenment, become a universal loving heart, divine soul. That divine soul can serve all sentient beings, bring happiness to all sentient beings, and liberate all sentient beings, and protect our world. So I want all human beings to concentrate to practice loving heart, and not to practice anger, not to practice selfishness, because selfishness and anger is our greatest enemy, and greatest obstacle which bring endless fear and suffering. So I want all human beings not to believe and practice selfishness, not to believe and practice the anger, and not to believe and practice greediness, because these are These negative emotions are our greatest enemy. And by practicing universal loving heart, by practicing supreme wisdom enlightenment, by practicing the spiritual divine technique, and by practicing meditation, I want all human beings to overcome everyone's greediness, everyone's selfishness, everyone's anger, everyone's ignorant, that all human beings become a universal loving hearted great human being who can love each other forever, who can protect each other forever, who can serve each other forever, and all together can protect our beautiful Mother Earth and beautiful planet. You know, so this is my request and my prayer for the world and for all human beings. Thank you for your coming here. Thank you. Jai Ho. All the sounds are sound of God, sound of universal peace. All sounds are sound of universal freedom. All sounds are sound of universal loving heart. All the sounds are sounds of Almighty God. All the sounds are sounds of Almighty Buddha. All the sounds are sound of our divine soul, you know. And all sounds have a natural blessing, natural effect, natural inspiration, which can purify our mind, which can transform our mind, and which can enlighten our mind. You know, so that's why we should believe that all sounds, all the voice are sound of God. You listen to all the sound of music, sound of singing, sound of normal sound, like sound of air, same sound of river, sound of wind. Believe all these sounds, the sound and voice of all phenomena are sound of God, sound of love, sound of peace, sound of universal freedom, sound of enlightenment. So when you believe sound, when you believe that all the sound, the voice and the singing, sound of music are sound of God, which inspire us, which bless us, which wake us up, you know. So if you develop this strong blessing, profound blessing, if you develop this profound believing that all sounds are sounds of love, sounds of God, which can bless all of us, which can wake up us, all of us, and which can unify everyone's heart with the heart of love, heart of peace. So that's why I think God can manifest, the blessing of God can manifest, the blessing of the divine nature can manifest, and the blessing of countless enlightened masters, enlightened angels can manifest through a different sound, through different music, through different rhythm, through different singing that can transform and bless our heart and our world. So I really appreciate, I really love music and singings, you know. And I was also not a bad singer. During my young age, I was 4 years, I was a good dancer, a good singer, and good musician, you know. So I know the beautifulness of the music and singing and all these things. So I absolutely joy that all of you are involved with the music and singing, and through your music and singing you can bless our world and wake up heart all human being and unify heart all human being into peace, love and happiness. Okay, thank you. Jai Ho, Jai Ho. We have this singing hand, you know. Yes, all these are singing. All these are Om, you know, Om. Mantra Om. Two phenomena meet each other. Or you kiss each other, you know. Two phenomena meet each other like this. Create a miracle of happiness. Create a miracle of a new existence. You know? So it's Om. Om. Om is mantra of universal peace harmony. The Om is the divine body of Almighty God, the divine body of infinite Buddhas. Everyone, every enlightened being's divine body come in form mantra Om, and it purifies the negative energy suffering of our physical body and transforms everyone's physical body into white light. And then we achieve universal everlasting peace harmony, which is everyone's divine body. You know? And mantra A. Mantra A purified the divine speech of Almighty God, divine speech of Almighty Buddha, divine speech of Almighty Allah, whatever you believe. The divine speech of infinite enlightened Buddhas and masters, everyone's divine speech come in form of mantra A in order to help to purify this the speech of everyone and transform the speech of everyone into divine red light. And we achieve universal everlasting freedom, which is everyone's divine speech. You know? A mantra, Hung, purified, ignorant, the divine soul of Almighty God, divine soul of universal loving heart, Almighty God, divine soul of universal loving heart, infinite Buddhas, enlightened masters, everyone's divine soul of universal loving heart, come in form of mantra, Hung, in order to help to purify the ignorant and egoism of mind of everyone. And we achieve universal everlasting loving heart and great bliss, enlightenment, which is everyone's divine soul, which is everyone's divine mind. So mantra Om Ah Hung is the mantra of our universal loving heart, mantra of universal peace and harmony, mantra of universal everlasting freedom, mantra which can purify our bodies and mind, mantra which can transform our bodies and mind, and ultimately the mantra can enlighten our bodies and mind. You can also look that I have composed a special prayer, special appreciation prayer to the land of Hungary. Dobogukö is like the palace of Almighty Holy Father of Universal Loving Heart. And Lake Balaton is Almighty Holy Mother, which can purify the suffering of the beings, you know. So the Dobogukö represent the Universal Loving Heart, Almighty God, which can purify the egoism of everyone. And Lake Balaton represent the supreme wisdom enlightenment of Holy Mother, which can purify the ignorant all human being. And that is the absolutely heart chakra of the world. Hungary is heart chakra of the world, where the world is transformed into a world of peace, world of unity, world of happiness. So I think, I always believe I'm a very ordinary being, you know? But my wish is also to purify our world, to transform our world into a world of peace, world of unity, and world of happiness. I was born with this attitude. So I spontaneously arrive in Hungary, and I feel whenever I give teaching in Hungary or initiation in Hungary, I feel I'm teaching in the heart, I'm teaching in the heart chakra of the world, in the heart of all human beings, through Hungary and Master Tanpai and Hungarians take universal responsibility to purify our world, to transform our world, and to enlighten our world. And this is the wish of God. So we are fulfilling the Hungarians and Master Tanpai, we are fulfilling the wish of God to purify our world, to transform our world, and enlighten our world, and we will make it. Okay?
Thank you.
And then now I have my lunches, I think.
Yes. Okay.
Say, you know, you have physical body master, you must Okay. But I you know from this interview, from you know, you can see how happy I am in Hungary. And how much I love and respect Hungarians.
Thank you very
Dragas. Much. Dragas. Dragas.
My last two city.
Oh my
this
gosh.
Is jazz city. This is a project with lot of children.
Oh my
children
God.
Core.
Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you, sweetheart.
It's a little contribution to.
Thank you very much, my dear. So you are going. You are going now, huh? I think. And my students, they all the teaching they put together as one small booklet. So I will ask Dusa. You know Dusa, Erika,
yes, yes,
that she will give five. She will after a few weeks she will be in Hungary, and we will she will present my booklet, which is composed by my Hungarian students. So
thank you.
Very much. All the best. All the best. Did you have your lunch?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. We just had so.
All the best. Saratik, saratik, Maja Rosa, saratik, Maja Rosak. All dog shagos. Draga.
Thank you very much.
Jaiyo, Jaiyo. Hungarians are my boss. One who love us, who accept us, one who love me or love anyone. One who love us, one who accept us, they are our best friend and they are our boss. Yeah? All right.
Thank you.
How you say Minden Age? Minden Age is always one, but we are one, how you say in Hungary?
Egyek vagyunk.
Egyek vagyunk.
Have this song here.
Ah, yeah.
Egyek vagyunk, one moment. here.
I think next time what we see is what we have a new band.
Okay.
That you sing and the middle I sing also.
Okay.
I sing also. I sing, you know. We can make a good team, you know.
Okay.
Really. I'm quite funny, you know, so it's easy to work with me, no problem.
Yeah.
All right. What's the name?
Brigitta.
What is your? This photo here? All the best, my dear. All the best. Okay. Oh my. Oh la la. Okay. Put all together here. This becomes Megu Lagush Junior.
Thank you very much.
Okay, subject of Megu Lagush Junior.
My instrument?
Oh my god, oh my god, this is medical. Yeah. Is it medical?
Yes.
So when you say, when you blow this and it's a beautiful sound, you say God is coming in the form of this sound. And bless yourself, bless everyone. No, you know. Okay. Jom dengan kamu nusa. So in beginning of May or end of April, I'm coming to Maja Rosa.
Oh really? End of April.
Anyway,
okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You keep touching with
me. Yes.
Kusunam drag.
Kusunam.
Kusunam.